Here we're going to look at finding the domain of rational functions. Now, as a quick reminder, if you hopefully will remember this, remember a domain is the set of all valid numbers or all valid inputs into a function. So, for example, if I have something like 1 over x plus 1 as a function, 1 over x plus 1, looking at this, I can plug in 0, right? Because that'll give me, I can plug in 1, I can plug in 2, I can plug in 3, and I get wonderful, beautiful answers. So far, everything seems pretty good. Now, what if I start with, so I did 0, 1, 2, 3. Let me work backwards. What if I put in negative 1? And I get this. And I know that this is undefined. So that means that the domain of this function, now if I keep going, I'll get this, so we're good, just so I make sure I cover all my bases. We're all good from there on. It's just this one stupid number that doesn't work. So that means the domain for this function is all numbers except, I should say all real numbers, or my math teachers would be mad at me. All real numbers except for negative 1. So pretty much how we usually write that is x is not equal to 1. So the domain of this, all the valid inputs are basically every single number except for negative 1, because negative 1 makes us divide by 0. So essentially what you're going to do in a lot of domain problems, for especially for rational functions, so rational functions means fractions. So like blah over blah. So whenever you're finding the domain for rational functions, your basic strategy here is to find where the denominator, that's the bottom number, is 0, and you want to exclude, you basically want to exclude those points, because that's where things go bad. So let's look at a couple of examples. So say we had something like, say we had some function that was equal to 3x plus 1 over x plus 2. And it says, find the domain. You go, okay, not a problem. I know that pretty much anything on the top is fine. Now what I don't want to have is something on the bottom equaling to 0. So I set that equal to 0. Subtract 2 from both sides, and I end up with x equals negative 2. So the domain is basically x is not equal to negative 2. Now the formal way to say that is to say x in set notation, such that x is a real number and x is not equal to negative 2. Now this fancy way of saying this is called set notation. And how we say this line means such that x is a real number and that it's not equal to 2. Got it? Good. All right, for another example, let's try to find the domain of, let's do this. Okay, got it, cool. Now in a problem like this, it might look scarier because it's got a cube on the top, but really, this is kind of a trick question because we know that we're okay as long as 2 doesn't equal to 0, and this never happens. So any x is okay Because I can put anything I want on the top, and there's nothing to divide by zero, so any x is okay. So in set notation, we'd say x such that x is a real number. And we're done. That's kind of a silly problem. So I'll do an actual real problem now. Say we had something like, find the domain of f of x is equal to, say something like, 7x plus 2 over x squared minus 2x plus 15, or something really crazy like that. Again, all we're going to do is we're going to take this denominator and we're going to set it equal to 0. And we're going to exclude those points. Okay? So this is, again, where factoring is going to come in. X and x, minus and minus, so let's go minus 5, minus 3. Whoa, that's not right. Did I do something wrong? No. Must have written the problem down wrong, because that's not solvable. Let's make that a minus 15. Better? Much better. Okay, so we've got, there we go, like that, come here. All right, so we've got plus 3x minus 5x, that gives me minus 2x, so we're good to go. So either x minus 5 equals 0, or x plus 3 equals 0. And go in here. Do-do-do-do-do-do. Bum-bum-bum, chomp and chomp. So all the numbers work except for those. So we can say x is x such that x is a real number, x not equal to negative 3, x not equal to 5. And depending on who your teacher is, they might have a special way that they want you to write it. Okay. Now, there's only one real trick that we can do, and it's not even a trick. If you're not paying attention, you won't even notice it. So say we want to find the domain of, say, f of x is equal to x plus 2 over x squared minus 4. Okay, and this comes with the one rule. Don't factor the original fraction. Okay? Don't factor the original fraction. Because what some people do, and these are usually the good students that do this, will say, okay, so I have this, let's try this again, x squared minus 4. So I'm going to simplify things, and I'm going to say that this is really x plus 2 times x minus 2. So I'm just going to cancel these out and get something like this. Now, algebraically, this is correct. Ooh, I canceled out the wrong one. So that was not correct. Now, algebraically, this is correct. But you're losing information. So don't do this when you're finding domain, because this loses information about the original problem. Okay, so we don't care, actually, that we can simplify it. What we care about is what the domain is of the original function. So don't go in, don't go factor it, just pretend that you don't know any better. Blindly pick this up. That looks terrible. Blindly pick up that x squared minus 4. Set it equal to 0. And go to town from there. And exclude both of those points. So here we're going to actually end up excluding a negative 2 and a positive 2. Whereas in if we factored it out, we'd only be excluding the positive 2. You want to exclude whatever needs to be excluded from the original way the problem is written. Okay, so x plus 2, x minus 2, so x plus 2 is 0, or x minus 2 is 0, so x equals negative 2, x equals positive 2. So in this case, x such that x is a real number, and x is not equal to 2, and x is not equal to negative 2. So we want to include, or exclude, both of these, which we wouldn't have done if we'd factored out the original problem. So I guess that's the only real trick about doing this, is not to exclude something, or to forget to exclude something that you really do need to exclude.